has no children, however, animals, she has a pug, Delilah, a pit bull, who's Luna, a mutt from Maya, and hobbies include concerts and road trips. Has been in Bakersfield for 22 years. Her burning desire is to meet Bono from U2. Something that no one knows about her is that she's bungee jumped three times, and she has been at the Grammys. I bet that was fun.
Oh, cool.
And then her keys to success is hard work, honesty, and always having new goals. Please help me welcome Taylor Brown.
Perform at the Grammys.
Oh gosh. You know what? It was before I could really appreciate it. I was in fourth grade. But I diehard remember meeting Steven Tyler and watching Tim McGraw perform.
Nice.
So, and Usher. You know.
Did you print up a fake ticket?
No. My dad, because he DJs, so it's part of the recording academy. So in the morning you can go to the Grammys.
Nice.
And there was only one sketchy bunch jump. That was in Mexico over a pool. I don't know why he let me do it. I was 12. So I'm only going to be up here for a second. I brought my dad to present because I'll just black out and read it all from a paper and it'll be 5 minutes long. So,
yeah. Okay, Kyle. What I'm actually trying to do today is I'm going to be speaking at a conference in Las Vegas in October. And they're basically like TED Talks. They're 10 minutes each. So this is my practice run. I barely finished this last night. There's gonna be a lot of things that are gonna change in this presentation throughout the next month, but looking for your guys' feedback. So what my 10 minutes are gonna be about in Vegas, there are 10 things you can do to improve your business in under 10 minutes. The presentation itself is supposed to take about 8 or 9 minutes because Q&A, I gotta get up on the stage and get off the stage. So, to start things off, one of the things you can do is network, of course. BNI being one of those things, going to events, having coffee, one-to-one, you know, events like that. So networking is a great thing that you guys can do to help build your business. Number two, and see, I already have a problem with the presentation over here, but be a part of something bigger. Help your community. Grow and help the nonprofits and the charities out there. That's good for your soul. It's good for your personal inner being. And when you're helping the community, it does come back and it does help you and it does pay you. Believe it or not, that feel good gives you more confidence in the things that you do and the presentations that you have and the customers that you meet. And you never know who you're gonna meet out there helping, okay? Never stop learning, right, Frank?
Right.
80-20. Read. If you don't read, like myself, I'm not a big reader. It's one of the best things I can do to put myself to sleep is read. Okay. I get through a couple of sentences and I start dozing off. But I listen to podcasts. I watch things on TV that are, sometimes they're entertaining, yes, but they're educational as well. There's a study out there, and I don't know if anybody here, most of you probably do know Zig Ziglar. He talks about the education of the car, the university of the car. And an average person who spends an hour a day throughout the day in the car, if you listen to podcasts or you listen to audiobooks or something like that, in 3 years you can get the equivalent to a 2-year college education. So take advantage of that time. You know, how long does it take you to get here to your office? You got a client that you're meeting out in Porterville or Delano. That's time in the car. Use it wisely, listen and educate. Take care of yourself, right? Doctor, talking about the nutrition and the health and the wellness. Jim Rohn, take care of your body, the only place you have to live. You don't get to go and sell it, put it in escrow, and get a new one.
It'd be nice.
Wouldn't it be lovely? You know, if you're a millionaire, you can go and get a new liver or a new heart. But you know, other than that, no. Dress for the job you want, not the job you have. If you want to be successful, present yourself as a successful person. Get up, take care. Again, a lot of these things tie back together, but get up, take care of yourself. You know, dress like you want to present yourself. That's how people will see you. Delegate. This is one I have a big problem with myself. I try and do everything. I don't want to put that burden on somebody else. I don't want to relinquish that. I want to make sure it's done the way I want it to do, but then I put in 17, 18 hour days. I am learning to delegate. I am learning to allow somebody else to do that and help me become more successful. And on top of that, I can do the things that I do best, whether that's presenting, getting up in front of people. I don't have a fear of public speaking. I enjoy it. I like being here. But the mundane things, it's better to pass them off on somebody who enjoys that part of it. So delegate. Master your presentations. Practice, practice, practice. You all have 60 seconds. And this is a pretty good group. I've listened to the 60 seconds a few times now. And I've noticed that a lot of times you do change it up. And you think about what you're going to say. But you have all these people right here that are there to help and promote your business. If you give them the information and the tools that they need to help you grow your business, you're going to be more successful. So master your presentations. Figure out what you're going to say. Write it down. Practice it a little bit. Collaboration. Working with other people. Okay? Kenyon and I could work together. He's doing promotional pins, and he's doing, you know, table runners and all kinds of stuff. But if they need a business card, I can take care of that. If they need a pen, he can take care of that. Collaborate with people who can help you grow your business. Help your customers. This one is a little bit unique. And people think, oh, well, help your customers. Yeah, you need business cards, I'll help you. No problem. That's a sale. Help your customers be better. Okay, I had a customer last night who is getting ID badges. Okay. And they hand me their business card, and they're like, no, it's fine. Just scan it in. Use the logo the way it is. To me, it looked bad. The logo was great, but a scanned in copy of an image just doesn't present well. It didn't take that long to have it vectorized, clean it up, tighten it up. They didn't pay for that. They didn't ask for that. They were satisfied with what was going to come out of the computer the way it was. I helped them, and now they're happier for it. And they didn't spend any more money. Take a break. Also, same thing, especially the doctors here will know this. A 10-minute break throughout the day. Just step away from the computer, step away from the phone, and take 10 minutes and breathe. Walk around the building if you have to. You'll be more productive. You will have better concentration. And you'll get more things done and actually be more successful. If you just take that time away, you're not going to lose 10 minutes. You're going to gain a lot more in the focus and productivity just by taking a little bit of a break once in a while and not being so frazzled. And lastly, of my 10 things, this is number 11. Support. To be successful, you have to have the support of your family and your friends and your mentors. These people are here to help you and guide you, because if you're successful, they're successful. So turn to your family and your friends for support. Have that network of people that you can turn to and say, hey, you guys are my support. What do you think of the presentation? Is it good? Is it clean? Where can I be better? Where can I do things? And it doesn't affect your customers, except for in a positive way. So that's my 8 minutes. Thank you, guys.